bone to pick with one angry video game nerd. At least once a week, one of your fans comments on my video saying that I am very similar to you. Oh yeah, an angry critic who's obsessed with the past? Never seen one of those before. But the fact of the matter is, these comparisons keep coming and coming and coming. As both you and I know, there is no comparison. I am by far the greater talent. I mean, you may have reviewed bad video games, but I reviewed bad movies based on bad video games, which is far worse. You may have reviewed the third Ninja Turtles movie, but I had the courage to review all three in a row. PS4, the fuck is it, still copyrighted. And you may have beaten the shit out of Bugs Bunny, but that's nothing. Here's a taste of what I do to myself.
Yeah.
called the Nostalgia Critic. And I remember it, so you don't have to. And he's been talking about me an awful lot lately. I have a bone to pick with one angry video game nerd. So here's my big comeback to you, Nostalgia Critic. You suck. It's satirical. The Nostalgia Critic and angry video game nerd both respect each other's work. Yeah, I got pens, and I'm not afraid to use them. It's satirical. Nobody really throws pens. I mean, yes, the pens might be in the store, but that's just an expression meaning that communication is more effective than brutality. Now you might be thinking, is that his comeback? Is that all he's got? Well, no. I got more. You're a poopy head. Can we spell out? You're a poopy head. Or at least let's hope, because if not, both these men are certifiably insane. You're even more insane to believe it.
I really like how you deciphered my hidden meaning. There is a hidden message inside of this comic. There's 38 words in the message. 38 words divided by 2 weeks is 19. It's
BS. Well, you're close. It was actually, lick my balls, you piece of shit Nostalgia Critic.
It's satirical. Nobody wants to lick anybody's shit or balls. Any angry vegan they would not prefer because they're just, nasty.
Yeah, we're pretty even. You did the Super Mario Brothers movie before I did. Well, I got to the wizard before you did, so in your face.
It's satirical. Nobody should care who reads what first and when. There's no official science sheet. If more than one person has seen the same movie, they can each express their opinions.
No matter how many YouTube channels you create, I am the domination of the internet.
Outside.
Let's go!
Yeah! words or something? Well, anyway, we got a deal here going on, where he does a shitty game, I do a shitty, nostalgic movie. Now, I hope it's nostalgic enough for you, and I hope it's shitty enough for you. Ricky One. Yeah, Ricky One. Never heard of it? Well, you heard of it now. It's the only feature-length spoof of Rocky that I've ever heard of. I mean, sure that there was a brief parody in Hot Shots and maybe like some comedy sketches on TV, but never a whole movie. It's so rare that, to tell you the truth, the only reason I know that was because sometime when I was a little kid, sometime in the late 80s, 89, I saw a video in the video store just sitting on the shelf like that. Yeah, just sitting on the shelf. I mean, right on the shelf in the video store, you know, just like that, just on the video store. So anyway, I didn't rent it. No, I didn't watch it. I never saw it, never heard of it. Nobody ever talked about it. Till many, many years later, I got curious. And you know what? I searched high and I searched low, and finally, this one copy popped up on eBay. And to tell you the truth, I wouldn't really be surprised if this was actually the same copy that I saw sitting in the video store, because I can't believe that more than one copy of this fucking piece of dog shit could even exist. So anyway, I didn't expect anything that good, to tell you the truth. I just expected maybe like a cheap knockoff of Naked Gun or Airplane or one of the National Lampoon movies. So yeah, I didn't expect it to be that good. But what I saw, oh god!
Ricky One, here we go. So this is our star. There's not really much to say. He dresses like Rocky, and his catchphrase is, "Don't be negative."
Hey, come on, don't be negative. Don't be negative. Oh, yeah, come on, don't be negative. Don't be negative. Hey, come on, don't be negative.
I don't get it. When does Rocky ever say that? Maybe it's a takeoff of absolutely. Yeah, Rocky always says absolutely, which means positive, which is the opposite of negative. So he says not to be negative because he's positive. Whatever. He's also a male stripper, which has nothing to do with anything. And why does he have a horse head? Is it supposed to be a takeoff of the Italian stallion? That's just bad. He's also a gigolo and sometimes dresses like a rabbit. Seriously. So Ricky is our Rocky, and Angela is our Adrian. Here's a little scene where she types him a letter.
I love you.
What the hell?
I love you.
There's also some guy who keeps randomly calling about some pornographic business.
Shove it, you scummy asshole.
What does any of this have to do with Rocky?
Asshole.
In the place of Apollo Creed is this guy which they keep calling the champ, that's all. Toward the end of the movie, they finally give him a name, the Silver Shadow, but most of the movie, he's just the champ.
He's like the champ? That's what I said. Hey, come on, champ's the greatest.
Well, beat him, and you can't be the greatest.
I can't beat the champ.
Why?
He's the champ.
Can't beat the champ, because he's the champ. Then there's this home security scene where some guy shows off an exploding doormat.
Shut up! You're mealy mouth coward!
What? Oh my god, an exploding doormat to keep burglars out. I always thought burglars coming through the window. And what if there's a mailman or a neighbor or something?
Okay, I'm still going on, there's more. Here's a scene which parodies The Godfather. Really that hard to understand? You know, it's actually probably one of the few moments where it comes close to being funny. But it's just stupid. Then there's somebody laying dynamite around. I seriously don't know what's going on. You might think it would make more sense if you saw the whole movie, not just random scenes out of context. But no, I assure you that I sat through this thing and it just blows my fucking mind. By the way, Hitler makes a cameo. Why? I have no idea. There's also a character called Dr. Foreskin and Officer Boner. Pretty funny, huh? There's a guy in the background giving a blowjob to a blow-up doll. X-ray? Y-ray?
Oh, come on! Well, anyway, I gotta wrap this up.
Toward the end of the movie, Ricky starts training to fight the champ. And this is when it finally starts resembling Rocky. But at this point, I don't even care anymore. I gave up a long time ago. There's this guy who becomes his manager and trainer, obviously supposed to be Mickey, but he doesn't make any effort whatsoever to imitate this character. It's like they just put the hat on and that's it. Where's his grouchy voice and wise ass remarks? The character offers us nothing. Hit that bag, did he get it? Old woman, bag. So the training goes on, they tie him up, throw punches through his face, he jogs backwards with his pants around his legs, and the famous weightlifting fall through the floor gag is a bad erection joke. There actually is a music cue hitting at the famous Rocky score, but when it happens, it's like, wow. So on to the boxing match. It's just a bunch of cheap gags. There's a bunch of farting noises. Then there's this guy talking with his hand wearing a gas mask. I don't get it. Oh, God. Oh, my God. Ricky won. Oh, thank God there's no Ricky 2. All I can say to you, nostalgia critic, is fuck this movie and fuck you for making me watch it.
That means...
Absolutely, I'm fine! I just wasted 5 minutes on this game and I haven't even pushed the button yet! Alright, so you're walking through this amusement park, though this isn't really as much walking as it is swimming through air, and you come across these people in costumes. They don't seem to be bothering me, so I just decide to move on. Oh, well, the screen won't let me leave. Okay, so I guess I have to beat these guys up. Okay, that's kinda cool. You get to hit people in the crotch. Maybe this game won't be so bad after all. Yeah, take that, you mousy gnats. Oh my god, I will never get tired of this. Oh my god, I am so tired of this. These characters take forever to kill, and they move around so much that they're hard even to hit. Wait, is it the one? Okay, that must mean I'm close, right? Thank god, I don't think I can take it much more of this.
Retire. I'm sorry.
not a big deal.
Yeah, to several points, you know, it's making waves, but. What?
Ah, yeah, but don't worry. I mean, it's not like you have to stop making your inferior videos.
And remember, I know a lot more muscular than we ever can. Just saying.